I think Jobs is in a, my sense, and from the people who are close to him that I talk to, my sense is that he's in a different place. In his life. I mean, here's a guy who faced death and seemingly survived and thrived.
Seemingly.
I mean, no one knows about these things.
Right. But he had a transplant, and he's much better than he was.
And he's much more animated, and he looks better in this presentation late January, and he's been active online and stuff like that. So thank God, and it looks like Steve Jobs is back.
He's traveling a bit, too.
Yeah, and he came here to make his pitch to the New York Times and Time, Inc. and the Wall Street Journal. So he made a very instructive speech at Stanford University several years ago, after he had been diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, and after he'd been operated on, told it was a success. And he spoke about death in that speech. It was a very personal speech. It was an 11-minute speech, and he's not a man who divulges personal feelings very often, and he did in this speech.
Is this the commencement address?
The commencement address
at the
Stanford.
Business school.
Yeah. And he, in that speech, he said, death is the great leavener. And what it does is that you know that everyone is going to die, yourself included. So live each day as if it's your last day and try and make a meaningful contribution. A really eloquent speech. And it was clearly heartfelt for someone who had faced death. And I think that experience, and then the experience some years later of finding out that, in fact, he was sick again and needed a liver transplant. What his friends say to me is that he is now determined to be the kind of partner he wasn't originally for the music companies, where he was much more belligerent, and he actually saved them in some ways and stopped the illegal downloading for music and offered people something the music company should have been doing, which is single records as opposed to buying. You have to buy the entire CD. But I think in this case, he talks about, and his friends confirm, that he wants to be a partner of traditional media, of publishers, of newspapers, and try and help them. If he means that, and so far it appears he does, they are standing up applauding. And some of them were there. Carolyn Reedy, the head of Simon & Schuster, was at the January 27th.
What did she say?
I quote her, she just was thrilled. And he came up to her and said, are you pleased? She said, more than pleased. I want one right now.